Hello and welcome to CBR TV. My name is John Bernstein. Today I'm joined by Elisa Costante from Forescout Technologies. Elisa, great to have you here. We're going to talk about OT, operational technology, and IT, information technology, the convergence between the two things, security. Before all of that, your role at Forescout.
Well, at Forescout, I am the senior director for the OT and Industrial Innovation Group. What that means is that I look at where the technology is going and I provide hints and ideas on what we can do from a technology perspective to actually face challenges from a security perspective now that IT and OT world are converging.
So let's talk about that convergence, the similarities and the differences between IT and OT.
Well, the thing is that every enterprise has both of those worlds, especially critical enterprise like energy distributor or manufacturing industries. The IT is typically the kind of industry that you use, that you see every day, the technology that you see with your computer, with your smartphone. The OT is becoming a bit more popular lately, but it's something that has to do with the industrial, with the operation. So it's the things that actually makes the products, so the things that allows the energy to move from a point A to a point B. Before, there used to be a gap between the IT networks and the OT networks. And now that everything is becoming smarter, that we need more data, that we need to predict, this gap is no longer existing. That means that the IT network is joining the OT network so that we can have more visibility on our production site, for instance, so that we can align better our business goals, understanding what the operation side is telling us. So this is what the convergence means.
And so that convergence is happening. Why does that make it so challenging from a security point of view?
Because nobody was thinking it was happening when they were designing the two systems. So whenever they were designing the OT networks, the assumption was this thing is never going online. Plus, the OT is not as fast moving as the IT. That means the technology that we see in the OT are legacy technology. You can think of them as old technologies. Most of them are now IP based, for instance, so they have an IP address. You have devices, they are called PLC, programmable logic controllers. Those are some computers of the old times, which allow, for instance, to control the speed of a train or to switch on or switch off switches in an electric grid. Now, these things, when were designed, they have a poor security. For instance, encryption is not there. Authentication is not there. That means that if you, because of a mistake, because of misconfiguration, you put this system online or reachable from the internet, for instance, you have quite a lot of troubles.
So I want to secure my OT infrastructure, and as it converges with IT, what are the things that I should be doing?
Device visibility. That's the first thing you need to do, is to know what you have. Most of the times, like when we engage with customers, they say, oh, our networks are hey, gut. We do not have anything connected to the internet there. That's not possible. And then when we go there and we actually see at their networks, so the solution that Forescout and the technology that we provide basically provides this visibility, allows you as a customer to have a clear idea of how many devices you have, how do they look like, are they vulnerable, how do they communicate with what other devices they communicate. And so with this visibility, for instance, you can understand if one device is connected to the internet or to a device from your IT network, and that should not happen because your policies and the NIS guidelines, for instance, tell you so. So one of the things that you might do is to understand if you have vulnerabilities, if you have misconfiguration, and then you can act upon those.
Elisa Costante, thank you very much.
Thank you.